Honorable Deputy Governor, Honorable Minister of Health, Director General, Ministry of Health, and Acting DG of Boer Hospital. It's a pleasure to be here this afternoon. I'm by the names of Honorable Michael Ayuen, a member of National Parliament, and a member of High Level Committee. We were moved by the death of our fellow board citizens, generals in our government, and one of whom was General Mabiyurkur, who happened to die in this hospital as a result of lack of oxygen concentrator. And so I had the privilege to share this with our diasporians, and mainly women in Australia, Boer Women Association Incorporated in Australia. I shared with them, and they were greatly moved and heartbroken. So they had to put their heads together and generate something. Boer Women, our Women Association in Australia, is under the leadership of Madame Teresa Akuch Gayo. They put their hands together and they raised some money and told me, Honorable Michael Ayuen, our problem is getting a conduit where we can pass or channel a good through to reach to the people on ground. And since we have you, if you can offer yourself to procure these concentrators, it will be of great help. And I had to offer myself. I went to Kampala, coordinated with medical equipment suppliers, and we were lucky enough to have 5 concentrators sent to us from UK. And we also ended up procuring also assorted PPEs, personal protective equipment, which were seen earlier on. And I also took my time to load them on the plane to Juba, and had a privilege to bring them this morning, received by Honorable Minister of Health, Atong Kuol Manyang. We went to the Secretariat, and Honorable Deputy Governor gladly received us with open hands, and was so happy to get the news of such a hand. Our people in diaspora said that they have the capacity to do something, but the problem is identification of what is to be done on ground has to be done by us who are here. We have to identify what we lack. It's not everything that can be done by them, but if they can send 5 machines, the government was able to procure only 3, I heard, and if they can, only Australia can send, and one association also can send 5 machines and other PPEs, that's a great thing. So as sons and daughters of Boer, whether in diaspora or in the country, what we need to do is to put our heads together, identify what is missing, share with our brothers and sisters, and see how we can put our efforts together to make that missing thing available. You can contribute your energy and time, somebody can contribute in kind, and somebody in cash. When you put all that together, it can make a great difference. Machines cost them about $7,000, 5 machines. Then the PPEs cost $900. Now transportation and up to here is what cost a lot, because they were considered as dangerous goods, DGs, at Entebbe Airport. But luckily enough, we happened to succeed eventually with the help of someone in the office of Ugandan President, and we finally got them here.
Samuel Majir, I'm the Director General in the Ministry of Health, Jonglei State. Today, actually, the 31st of March, we have received the donation from women association in Australia. And this is not the first time, because in the past they have donated to Bor State Hospital, but today also we are very thankful that they have provided five oxygen concentrators, so that this machine actually will use them in COVID-19 isolation center, where the patients who are having difficulty in breathing can be safe, including children. So actually we are very glad for this donation, and we want to continue with you as we can. And so this is what we just want to say, thank you very much.
As you've heard already, the introduction has already been made. The source of this equipment is from Australian Women Association.
Bor Women Association in Australia.
Bor Women Association in Australia. And we know that they've been doing a lot in the past. This is not the first time. And when we inform our Honorable Deputy Governor, Honorable Antipas Nyok, he had to find time to come here, because it's very important. It's important for the state, it's important for the ministry in particular. And I brought to his attention that although these people have brought a lot of equipment, we've had some few challenges, especially the ultrasound that we have, and we also have X-ray machine. So these are some of the challenges that I brought to his attention, and we will work together with Honorable so that these things that are brought to us will be put in use. And we know even US, they've also been doing the same. And all the diasporans, as you mentioned earlier, they've not forgotten where they came from. And that is a very good thing. As I said earlier, we are working collectively as a team. Otherwise, I will give it to Honorable Deputy Governor.
Please, viewers of South Sudan Television at large, all over the country, today we are very glad to have received some donations being brought by our brother, Honorable Ayuen. This gift was brought by the Bor Women Association in Australia. They contributed the details that they would have used for their families to share it with their brothers and sisters at home, especially in the field of health. We have just received the machines. These machines, which are the containing the oxygen, the oxygen has become so useful, especially in this particular time of COVID-19. We lost a number of people all over the country simply because of the lack of oxygen. So our women, Bor women in Australia, they took it as a burden and took it upon themselves to try to contribute a lot to come and help our people at home. So we thank them a lot for their contribution, and we thank our brother Ayuen for taking a burden all the way going to East Africa to go and process these things and bring it to us here to be available at home. I believe with the help of our minister Atong Kuol Manyang and the team in the Ministry of Health, led by our young doctors, we hope all these machines will be operationalized and they will save lives, very many lives of our people that would have otherwise been lost simply because of the lack of oxygen. So we thank the Bor community at large, and specifically Bor women in particular, for this contribution. In the past, some of our diaspora, especially in the USA and other parts of the world, contributed also a machine worth $50,000
for the same
women association. So they have contributed a lot. So in terms of saving lives of the people at home, so these machines, some of them are not yet used, but they will be operationalized now with the presence of our Minister of Health. All these machines will be operationalized. There will be no more going to other parts of the outside the country because of the lack of ultrasound or because of the lack of oxygen. So very many things will be, many lives will be safe here at home. So we thank our young doctors for also taking care of this equipment in the right way. So we highly, on behalf of the government of Jonglei State, we are wholeheartedly appreciating the efforts of our diaspora, Because our diaspora has been playing a lot of role, South Sudan diaspora, since the time of liberation struggle. So we still urge them to continue their support, because the struggle to save lives have not yet been ended, and we are yet to struggle also to improve our livelihood. So thanks a lot for the effort, and may God bless you and bless all of us.
Thank you.